ドは本当にこう自分の娘のような存在です。まあ本当に、24時間ね、1日あるとしたら18時間はそのプライドとともに生きてる、そのプライドのために自分自身が何ができるのかってことを毎日考えて、ほぼこの10年生きてますのでですね、まあ本当にこうかけがえのない娘のような存在です。まあ本当に人類の中で、常にこれ永遠のですね、こう古代ローマの時代から永遠のテーマで、誰が一番本当にこの世で強いんだっていうのは、これは人間の永遠の命題だと思うんですね。それに本当に答えを出したいと。だから常にこの10年間プライドっていう場所は、その時点での世界最強のところは誰なんだっていうコンセプト、そのテーマを追い続けてる。でそれをこう実証してみせる場所、実際にこう、それを競技の枠を超えて、ルールを超えて、それをこう見つけ出す場所に本間は作りたいというのが一番の、今もなおプライドのテーマだし、プライドのこう存在意義という感じですね。
1997, Pride Fighting Championships made its debut at the Tokyo Dome in Japan. It would become an event whose impact would forever change the landscape of mixed martial arts. 10 years later, Pride Fighting Championships has become the worldwide leader in the sport of mixed martial arts. This is the story of legendary fighters from across the globe, the men who made this the Pride Fighting Decade.
The first Pride event was a landmark. It set the standards for all the other events who were planning to be good or great. They should have aimed to look like that. And to fight there on the same card as Hickson was fighting was a great honor. And I said yes right away, like I couldn't not even, I almost explode of happiness like to be on that card. And when I got there, that I first the arena,The Tokyo Dome was something like out of a movie. Like I could not even understand how they work, like a dome that is held by air. And it was something very new, like a 65,000 seat arena. And by what they told me, the house would be full that day, I couldn't just believe it. It was the greatest show I have ever seen, the greatest fighting show I have ever seen in my life.
やっぱりそれは自分の中でもそうですけども、プライドの歴史を、今10年経って振り返ってみても、間違いなくプライド1での高田ヒクソン戦ですね。
That fight really put Pride on the map. It brought the mixed martial arts legend in against the most popular fighter in Japan and the person who really Pride was about. And that really set everything running for Pride and brought all the fans there that remained fans.
Hickson Gracie,being the very skilled fighter that he is in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and coming from the famed Gracie family, that's the stage. Pride is the stage for the world's best fighters. So Hickson Gracie, Pride 1 makes sense. Now Takada coming from the pro wrestling world, that's where the spectacle comes in. You know, the huge entrances, the great show openings, the fireworks, the music, the whole pro wrestling show comes from Takada. So you got the best of showmanship from the pro wrestling with Takada.With the best fighters in the world and Hickson Gracie representing them, and Pride 1 was the launching pad for what you see today, and it's just getting bigger and better each year. But it all started back in the day with Hickson and Takada.
Hickson is the champion of our family, one of the most amazing specimens I have ever seen in my life. and he never disappointed. It was always a walk. He walked through his opponents like they were made of butter and like he was hot iron. I remember his first fight against Takagi, and I had the chance to be right on his corner and telling him, trying to help him through the time, and it was an amazing experience, like to see such a sharp jiu-jitsu in such a sharp shooter. Like, it's the perfect combination. He's the perfect athlete with the perfect technique.
He's gonna go for armbar.
There it is.
There you go. Oh, he's got it. He's got it. Takada's got the hands locked. Takada taps out. That was a quick one, folks.
なぜならその高田信彦とヒクソンの試合で、高田信彦がヒクソンに勝っていたら、そのプライド1は、プライドっていうものは1で終わってたんですね。それで完結してしまって、次に高田信彦がヒクソン・グレイシーとリベンジする必要もなかったし、歴史は続かなかった、一夜限りの、夢の舞台で終わってたので、そこで高田選手がやっぱヒクソン・グレイシーという選手に壮絶に4分47秒でですね、負けたという、その圧倒的な現実が、リアルな現実が、あったからこそ、今のプライドの歴史があるので。まあ、私にとってもプライドにとっても一番大切な試合は間違いなく第1回目1997年10月11日の高田ヒクソン戦だと思います。
And I remember like after the event we sat down to talk later and he was like, hey, could you believe how beautiful that event looked, how perfect everything was, how the timing and everything was insane.
そうだね、まあそれまでやってきたことが格闘技ごっこだったなっていうね、本当にこういろんなことが絡み合って重なり合ってプライド1のヒクソン戦にたどり着くわけだけど、まあ、その時点で初めてだね、格闘技の総合格闘技の、まあ、深い深い、先の入り口にやっと立てたなと。
If it wasn't for that fight, there wouldn't be a Pride. It sort of set a standard for creating super fights. And I believe it also set a standard at the time for wages and purses paid to fighters. And it was not just a couple of top fighters, it was two superstar personalities getting in the ring at the same time.
It's difficult. Like, people may watch a tape today and a DVD, and I don't believe they will ever grasp the whole concept that we had the chance to see.Because me, Hickson, and some other guys, we had the chance to have the best seat in the house inside the ring. So I look at that from inside the ring. I look at my opponent across the ring, and I could see the whole arena packed of strange faces. But to me, it was very reconforting the fact that I was at home on my habitat, which is inside the ring.You know, that's why when I finished, I just couldn't see no other place that I could go fight but Pride, because it was everything perfect.